I like to talk about observers and be very clear about what I'm talking about. They can be either tiny or huge. So tiny would be like an electron, which is a point particle. Can't get much tinier than that. We've got the positive number past and the negative number future. Or you could go like really big, galaxies, because they observe their local galactic clusters and all that kind of stuff, and you can do math on that. Now, both of these have a here now, now being the first number, here being the other three. And we know the math, 0 + 0 = 0. 0 × 0 = 0. And that means that every observer is stuck at here now. And I call this my inverse Mach principle. I think observers are the key. All right, so complex numbers, used all the time in quantum mechanics. It's got a real imaginary, but what does it physically mean? Well, with space-time numbers, which is a slight generalization, aka quaternions, I know what that means. Time, there's one of them, and it's a real number. And there are three space terms. Now, it's well known that Einstein had all kinds of issues with quantum mechanics, so we're going to make him the observer and give him a little magnifying glass here. He's in a light cone, which is actually very comfortable in, because light cones have to do with causality. We got the past there as a positive number. We got here now. And we've got the future, which is a negative number, at least according to me. We're going to give him a nice big plane to do his experiments. And over here, he digs a trench, does the whole trench thing. And we'll just say that's at 0, 1, 0, 0. That first one means it's now at location 1. And now we put another trench in at a different location, 0, 0, 1, 0. We got an orange tabby cat. We got a red cat. But these are going to be part of our experiment, so we have to put them in the trenches. So the red cat goes in that one, and the orange one goes over here. Cool. Oh, yeah. I got to put in the explosives. All right. I'm sorry. It's the way it goes. So we're going to count down or count up. Let's see. And 1, 2, 3. Oh, 60. I counted really quickly. Now, this is Einstein. We send photons as quickly as we can. Green ones for living, red ones for dead. Oh, that was green. Good. And both lived. That is cool. So if we square this 0, 1, 0, 0, we get -1. Einstein gets it in the future, 1 unit later. Okay, so we're going to repeat the experiment. So we have to redo the trigger things. And I thought, I don't know, let's really change this up a little bit. Let's just move this second trench out a bit further. So Einstein's going to get this information later, because it's located in a different place, which you can kind of do with the space-time numbers in a way that makes sense. Oh, look, I just repeated it. Green lived. Oh, red died. I'm sorry to report that, but it's an experiment. So there's the RIP. And so there's this notation they use in professional circles. It's called bracket notation. And we just know that you do this enough times, it comes out to a half. So after Einstein knew one of them was red, lived, it would be that and the bracket notation. And then once we knew both pieces of information, well, we know both pieces of information, so it's not a big deal. And what I like to say is that's two state dimensions versus four space-time dimensions. That's Schrödinger's cat.